Okay, so the other topic I introduced tonight, we're going to go into more detail about this as well, these are the two main things really, is this whole business of karma. It's Buddha's deal, you know. So again, remember Buddha is not a creator, okay? That means if you try to take it as a hypothesis, we're assuming that what Buddha says and the teachings are valid, you know, these are not my recipes here, I'm quoting my sources, okay? I'm a person who's writing my mummy's recipes, I'm giving you Buddha's recipes. And I got these from my teachers, who got them from their teachers, who got them from their teachers. That's why my mother, who was a musician, got it from her teacher, who got it from her teacher, and you could track it right back to Bach and Mozart, couldn't you? Same here. So I'm not owning these recipes. These recipes I'm giving you are Buddha's recipes, coming through the mouths of my Tibetan Buddhist teachers. So the Buddha's view about karma is, again, from Buddha's observations. His observations, it's not information coming from on high. It's not speculation, and he hasn't made it up, which is what creator means. He hasn't, it's not his job. He's observed. What he says is reality. It's like somebody who observes, you know, botany, or observes, you know, gravity. They're natural laws. That's exactly how Buddha talks about karma. So, the mind as well. So what's karma? Well, we use this word, it's used very colloquially, even among most Buddhists, and inaccurately too. You know, often you think it was a big stick. It's used to beat you when you're naughty. It's almost like an equivalent of God, you know? It's so incorrect. So what it's referring to is the law of karma. You can start that. Buddha says a natural law. And it's what this law of karma, it plays out in the minds and lives of sentient beings. No one else. And minds do karma. So the word karma literally means action, I think, in Sanskrit. But what it's referring to, the most tasty thing it's referring to, is the beginning of the process of quote-unquote creating karma. It starts with the mind. The thought. As long as the Rinpoche says, everything exists on the tip of the wish. The intention. So you all know, if you see me suddenly stand up and walk towards that door, you know you can deduce absolutely logically that the thought arose in my mind, I will walk out that door. We know that. The legs don't have their own little mind, you know. The legs don't, they do what the mind says. But because it's all so instinctive, we don't join the dots, you know. So that's the meaning of karma. Intention, I will, or volition, intention. That's the first step in the process of karma. And without that, there's no karma. So we'll go into it all. So it's the law of karma. According to Buddha, his observation is, this is what runs in lives and minds. The law of karma determines the kind of person you are, the rebirth you get, your tendencies, your experiences at the hands of others, and even the way the external environment impacts upon others. All of this comes from the beginning of the process of intention, and then intentions, wishes, are they not, in many cases, carried out by the servants of the mind, which are called the body and the speech. So this is the process of quote-unquote creating karma. And Buddha narrows it down to two essential things. The so-called negative actions, which is an action, the first level of it, is an action of the body or the speech that's impelled by a negative state of mind.